The Philippine Interior Department slams Facebook for flagging a recent post by National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon Jr. Last week, Esperon said on his profile, Filipinos should unite against members of communist rebel groups, including those whom he claims have infiltrated Congress through the partyless system. The social media giant issued a restriction warning on the post, saying it violated community standards. Interior Undersecretary Jonathan Malaya called Facebook's move alarming and offensive. He urged the platform to revisit and modify its standards, questioning why it was restricting the accounts of government officials. Esperon himself denounced Facebook and asserted the legitimacy of his statement. Presidential candidate Leody de Guzman is back in Manila following Tuesday's shooting incident during his campaign activity in Bukidnon. De Guzman and members of his Senate slate were there to amplify the Manobo Pulangyon tribe land-grabbing complaint. Five people were hurt in the incident, including the head of a farmers group and the leader of the tribe. De Guzman blames Quezon Bukidnon Mayor Pablo Lorenzo III over what happened, accusing him of land grabbing. Lorenzo denies the allegation.
Wala naman akong kasalanan, hindi naman ako magnanakaw. At saka tingin ko, hindi naman ako yung target. Bagamat yung unang putok ay talagang tumba yung katabi ko. Dito pala sa Mindanao, hindi uso ang dialogue. Hindi pala uso dito ang warning shot. Agad, tinitira yung mga pumuntang mga katutubo. May kultura na ng impunidad. Dahil doon sa nangyaring sa nakaraang 6 na taon, ay wala nang ginawa kundi magpatayan dito sa ating bansa. Yan ang problema.
Senatorial bet David DeAngelo, who captured the incident on video, vows to push for reforms to help indigenous people in their struggle if he wins the elections.
Sabi ko nga, wag na kami yung alalahanin eh. Yung mga nandun na katutubo na talagang antagal nang nagtitiis sa napalabas sa kanilang sariling lupain. Kaya nga, pinuporsyon namin yung anti-dynasty bill, no, para talagang mapaayos yung ating sistema ng gobyerno. Kasi impunity to eh. Diba itong mga katutubong to, walang kalaban-laban. Actually, share ko lang din, no, habang pinabaril kami, sinasabihan pa ng mga namamaril, labas kayo dyan, labas, labas. Parang mga daga, parang mga hayop na pinaputokan. So, I think it's supposed to be something that has to be changed also by law and implementation.
The Philippine National Police vows to conduct a thorough investigation into the shooting incident during the campaign activity of De Guzman. It adds, it's premature to say that the incident is election-related. PNP's Region 10 director says they have determined several personalities who may be linked to the land-grabbing dispute.
We are trying to find out talaga kung yung galing tanong nyo kanina, yung mga who are the perpetrators yung shooting na yon. Tama ba yung ginawa nila? Are they allowed to carry firearms, especially so election time? Anong firearms na ginamit? Pag may papel ba?
The COMELEC withholds a 90 million peso payment to its automated poll technology provider, Smartmatic. That's after the National Bureau of Investigation revealed an alleged data breach within the company's operations. Johnson Manabat reports.
On December 28, to January 2 of 22, Smartmatic already detected some unusual behavior as to their logs or the traffic in their system. December 29.
May I interrupt, Mr. Lorenzo? Is this admitted by Smartmatic? Unusual traffic and downloads already observed as early as 28 December?
Maybe the term, Your Honor, is not... We admit that, Your Honor, in the company intranet server, there was a unusual heavy access of the files, Your Honor.
The Philippine National Bureau of Investigation revealed this at the Senate Committee on Electoral Reforms and People's Participation hearing on the alleged data breach at the Smartmatic system. NBI Cybercrime Division Chief Victor Lorenzo narrated the timeline of events of the alleged illegal access of Smartmatic system in 2021. Lorenzo said, in August 2021, Smartmatic hired Ricardo Argana as their quality assurance officer and deployed in November 2021 at the COMELEC warehouse to run some tests in the Automated Election System or AES. According to Lorenzo, On December 28, 2021 to January 2, 2022, Smartmatic detected some unusual behavior to the traffic and downloads logged in Smartmatic systems.
So on December 29, completion of test in Comelec warehouse, that's when the time their former employee brought his laptop outside the premises of Comelec. January 3, 2022, he reports back to the premises of Smartmatic in Taguig and brought back the laptop that he took from the premises of Comelec. January 9 detects unusual traffic in their system using VPN logs, downloads, and were traced to the former employee of Smartmatic.
Lorenzo adds, Argana admitted his transactions with a third party to access the Smartmatic system.
In the administrative inquiry conducted by Smartmatic, he only admitted having been promised training modules in exchange for allowing them, the third party, to access his laptop in order to be connected to the Smartmatic facilities. But when he appeared in our office, he admitted that he was also promised, aside from the training modules, he was also promised money ranging from 50,000 to 300,000, Your Honor.
Maraming sinasabi yung NBI. Humihingi rin sila ng second executive session. Mm-hmm. Kasi mukhang marami pa silang alam na hindi nila pwedeng ipahiwatig sa panahong ito dahil kasagsagan pa rin ang investigasyon nila.
Even with Smartmatic's legal counsel admission that there is an unusual heavy access in their system, he reiterated that there is no hacking in the system and this incident will have no impact in Comelec system.
And we are quite sure that there is no cyber attack in our system because in the first place in Santa Rosa, it's not connected in internet. So with that,
Comelec officials also assured the public their system was not hacked. Last April 12, the NBI already filed cases against Argana at the Taguig City Prosecutor's Office. Senator Marcos said they are willing to have a second executive session to hear more sensitive information from the NBI. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.